Working with the emotional body requires you to have an increased experience of the feelings inside your physical body and also in the auric field around you. Please understand that the mental body greatly composes the aura itself, and the emotional body is more concentrated within the physical form, even though the emotional body is an energetic body. It's not the physical body. They're overlapping in many ways, but they're different. And so, first we are going to work to calm this inner emotional body. During our lives, we have the experience that certain emotions are constant. They're who we are. Please understand that the way we perceive life is by recognizing change. And so, when we have a constant emotional experience, we will think it to be the foundation, what is normal. We won't realize the energy we had until we change out of that. In your own life, you may have experienced a great increase of happiness in your life. And in that moment, it dawns on you how unhappy you were previously in your life. You were always carrying that unhappiness. It was part of who you were. It was constantly in your energy body. And only through changing yourself did you realize where you were at before. And so our mind registers the changes in our experience. If something doesn't change, we believe it to be just how life is. And so often people will ask me to describe my happiness, or they will believe that they have this great happiness already. We don't know the degree of our happiness until we work to increase it. Most human beings may be happy, but they don't know how happy they can become. They don't know how much bliss or love they can experience until they work to expand themselves, until they purify themselves and remove that which's holding them back. And so in my experience, there's always room for growth. There's always more happiness available to me because the entire energy is creating so much bliss, more bliss than I can keep in my body. There's always the opportunity for me to increase my clarity of mind, increase my inner peace, increase my divine love experience. And so I recognize that I'm always in a state of change. Everything is always in a state of change. By having this idea first, we give ourselves permission to move away from the status quo of our emotional energy. We move away from that solid foundation that we thought was normal or was who I am, and we change into something different. And so the biggest obstacle to spiritual growth is not gaining new knowledge. It is not gaining new experiences. The biggest obstacle is releasing that which we are holding on to, that which we are identifying with as who I am. And so we release that. And in that release, we naturally start to move forward. And then we can reflect on who I was. And through reflection on our past, we understand more who we are and also more where we are going. And so in your emotional body right now, you have the status quo of energy. We're going to try first to help you realize this. Just become aware of how you feel right now. This will create the baseline, the foundation from which we will continue to work. As I've taught in many of these teachings, we must honestly and openly understand and experience what is happening right now. We must always stop, or excuse me, we must always start with open and honest experience of what is. We must accept the present moment just as it is. Even before we work to change our experience, we must understand the experience we are having. Then we will know how to accurately create change. Oftentimes, our spiritual teachers, or books, or people we learn from, will immediately encourage us to work and to do and to create. Rarely will they tell us to be with ourselves and to understand ourselves. Many of our creations fail because we do not understand who we are. We do not understand what we are trying to change. Often, the action of always looking outside and always moving forward is rooted in the denial or the repression or the ignoring of who we are. We must understand and experience who we are first, and then we can move forward. And so in this video, I'm going to guide you to have an open and honest experience of your emotional energy system just as it is. This is going to effectively break down your subconscious mind's actions of denial and repression. This is extremely important. We often think that who we are right now is perfect. We often think that our status quo emotions is happiness. But we don't realize what we're missing out on if we're holding on to who we think we are. Oftentimes, we defend ourselves, our behaviors, our emotions, and our attitudes to other people and to ourselves. This defense is a form of denial and repression. We create a wall of anger so people don't see what's inside of us. We create a wall of anger so we don't see and feel what's inside of us. The ego greatly tells the world who it is. We tell people who we are, what we believe, how important we are, in order to hide from the fear. In order to hide all those things inside of us. We're so busy talking, so nobody will see what's in us. We're so busy doing, so we don't have to stop and be with ourselves and feel that baseline of emotion. Most human beings are living on the outermost periphery of themselves. They're living in the space between their senses and the world. Their thoughts are controlled by what's happening in the senses. Their emotions are controlled by what's happening in their senses. And so they're always doing and acting and looking and listening so greatly outside themselves to ignore what's inside themselves. And so all the efforts to grab at new spiritual knowledge or new types of experiences are only happening out here. They're not going deep inside and changing our emotional suffering, changing our emotional patterns. I hope you can understand what I'm referring to because I'm trying to talk about that which is intangible. It's not a physical object, but it's the experience of ourselves as being human. And so when the objects in the material world control what you're thinking about, and determine the actions you create, most often you're living on the outermost part of yourself. So we must try to move our awareness inside. Most effectively, this is done with meditation because we silence the external stimulus coming through our senses.